On the banks of the Tennessee River, we're in Knoxville, Tennessee at Neyland Stadium. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Tennessee is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. From his own goal line. They'll bring him down at the 24-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Caught and up for the first down. And he's tackled at the 35-yard line.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's hit and taken down. Tackle at the 38. It's the senior corner who nails the quarterback for the sack.
Nice call here, but they might want to wait a while before going back to it again.
Haggerty is the punter. Gets to about the 34-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Caught and big hit there to stop him. From their own 35-yard line. It's second down. Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. To bring on the punt team.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Brooks is waiting for the snap. Tackle at the 19. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. He's wrapped up for the sack. Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. He's scrambling. Tackle made around the 18-yard line. Screen here, and the halfback's got it. Knocked out of bounds at the 17-yard line. And that was a nice stretch for the D there.
Yeah, they really cranked it up a notch on that series.
The secondary decided to drop back into coverage here, and there was nobody open for the quarterback to deliver the ball to. Good job by the D.
He's at midfield, brought down at the 45. There's a flag down, and it looks like this one's coming back. That one will put the offense in a hole, and they'll try to get some of that back on this upcoming play. From their own 40-yard line, first down. Brought down at the 42-yard line. Third down, two to go. Ball on the 48-yard line. Once and all, going deep. It's going the other way. He just jumped up and snatched that ball.
Well, there, I don't think the quarterback even saw him. The defender went up into the air and made a great catch.
From their own 26-yard line, it's first down.
Three down. Check number six. Check
number six. Down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. And he's immediately tackled. Nice pickup as they connect on the pass play.
Well, they look to be in sync right now. They're both reading the defense properly, and the result is a nice game.
He scrambled. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's finally shoved out at the 31.
They're eating up a lot of field on this drive. I'm really impressed with their ball control.
There.
It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
And down he goes at about the 19-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. The five, and he's taken down at the 3. First down, first and goal. You're going to go play action inside the 5. Here's the time to do it. Looking for the corner. He's tackled around the 1-yard line. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. And they make the stop at the 2-yard line.
Really good play here in run support by the linebacker. The big guys up front took away the running lanes, and he was able to get through for a loss.
This is a very important play for both teams. It's third and goal from the 2. They'll bring him down around the 4-yard line. 2-yard loss.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
This one should be makeable. Western Kentucky could take the lead with this field goal. The lineman got a little ahead of the snap count. Here's the call.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
It's up, and it is good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
They line up to kick this one away. Fielded at the four. And down he goes at the 33-yard line.
Well, this has really been stingy by both of these defenses. The question is, can they keep this pace up, though?
I think that's a big challenge for them to be able to continue to play like this. Right now, the emotion of the game is favoring the two defenses, but I get a feeling it's a matter of time until one of these offenses starts clicking.
And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Just throws this one away.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 33.
Here we go.
And he throws it away. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. There's a strike over the middle. And he tackles him hard at the 43. Brooks awaits the snap. He gets hit out of bounds at the 28. The Hilltoppers really taking care of business early in this football game.
Yeah, somebody forgot to tell them they're the big underdog in this game. They're supposed to lose. I love their confidence that they're playing with right now.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Western Kentucky holds a field goal lead. And he's tackled at the 34-yard line. Walker gains 6 yards with a short completion. Nice gain as he works the right side. Right around midfield. Slings it, and he's hit immediately. He goes out of bounds at the 35. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Somebody hit the upset alert button because this one looks like it just might be heading in that direction. 3-0, Hilltoppers. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Western Kentucky has a 3-point lead. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. They'll call on the field goal unit. Kicks up. They head to the sideline with nothing to show for that drive. And our score, 3-0, Western Kentucky. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Hit before it can go anywhere. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. He wants it all. It's intercepted. And he is drilled at the 25.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw, and that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
From their own 25-yard line, first down. Got it, and he goes down quickly. They got 4 yards on that one.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
And he hits him hard at the 43-yard line. Western Kentucky is up a field goal. Pass is caught, the defense lays him out.
All day, just like that.
Check 99.
Nice run up the middle. Decent pickup. Quick pass. So they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
It was a great read by the quarterback there to take the snap and throw it quickly to get the first. Just throws this one away. From the 34-yard line, second down.
You ain't doing nothing today. Mark 27.
And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. It's the junior corner. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
From their own 18-yard line, it's first down. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Here's third and 9. Ball on their own 19. Looking for his man, incomplete. Brooks to punt. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Western Kentucky is up by 3. He's on the run. That's a great tackle at the 31.
I'm telling you, quarterbacks who can run the ball are so hard to stop. You have to scheme around them, which takes the best coverages out of your defensive playbook.
He's going to try and scramble. They bring him down.
Sometimes it's just a relentless pass rush that results in a sack. That's what happened there.
Now Now he's scrambling. Tackle made at the 36. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Haggerty is waiting for the snap. He's out to the 30.
Hand him out, hand him out.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
They give to the tailback. He fights forward to about the 33. From their own 33-yard line, second down.
Ready! 550!
He's at the 40. Tries to thread the needle, and it's not going to work. Brought down at the 38-yard line. Good job to pick that ball off.
He did a great job at getting in that passing lane and coming away with the ball.
First and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line. Western Kentucky holds a field goal lead. Scrambling around. Dives for extra yardage. He makes his way to about the 18. He's taken down at the 8-yard line.
Too easy, too easy.
Run there.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
Rosen is caught for the touchdown. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 5-play, 38-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 10-0. Tackle at the 23. Both defenses really played well so far, Herbie.
Well, up to this point, both defenses have dominated this football game. We'll see if they can hold on to that mentality the rest of the way.
Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
If they can play sound football from here out and make a few plays, there's no reason they can't get back into this.
And he's immediately tackled. From their own 35-yard line, first down. Steps out of bounds, right around the 38-yard line. That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
So it's second down and 15 after the penalty.
Check down, check down. 81, 81.
He's out of bounds at about the 45. come out in a 5-wide set. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Makes a catch, and he's got nowhere to go. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws it.
And they make the stop at the 37. From the 37-yard line, first down. And down he goes around the 23-yard line. From the 23-yard line, it's first down. Fires incomplete.
Wow, Brad, you talk about having a strong arm. Next time, though, he might want to work on the accuracy.
It's the ninth play of the drive. They'll spread the field with five wide. Now he's flushed and they got him.
Easy, easy, easy. Big dog, big dog.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
You can bend a bit as a defense, but when they're this deep in your own territory, you just can't break.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Might have been some early movement up front.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
He gets it up, and he got it.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalked up 3 points for the offense.
10-3, Western Kentucky. Tennessee is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's taken down at the 29-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Western Kentucky is up 7. And he throws right away. It's picked off. It's the junior. And just a great interception by the cornerback.
Well, that's big time. He made a great read on the quarterback and got in there for the pick.
From the 44-yard line, first down. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled around the 37-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. They'll bring him down at the 29. Great first half of action, and we're hoping for more of the same. 10-3, Western Kentucky.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. The Hilltoppers probably looked at this game as a great opportunity to explore their depth. See how many guys they could get, maybe get a few more guys to letter by the end of the season.
Yeah.
Now all of a sudden, they can't afford to do that. The game's too close.
Yeah, I guess somebody forgot to tell the other team that. Hey, we're just using you as a punching bag. You, just come out here, you know, get absolutely destroyed in the first half. And then we're going to put our scrubs in. We're going to put the guys that don't really get a lot of reps in. And, yeah, as a coach, you'd like to develop depth. You'd like to have that opportunity. But if the players don't come out ready to play and don't execute, you're not afforded that opportunity. Do some of those guys maybe deserve some playing time after the way those other guys have played the first half? Yeah, but your idea of bringing the scrubs in to finish the ballgame, that might have gone out the window in this first 30 minutes.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Gibbs from the six. He's out to the 30. And he's taken down at the 32-yard line. Kirk, I remember you had nights like this.
He's made a lot of mistakes up to this point. But you know what? He's got a track record. And I think, I believe personally in watching him, that he has the ability to turn this game around and to finally get into his rhythm and get this offense going.
If he can put those picks behind him, he's still got a chance to pull out the victory. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Tackle around the 39-yard line. 7 yards there.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
They're about 4 yards away here on second down. He's tackled at the 50. Picks it up, and they'll bring him down behind the line. From midfield, it's second down. He fights forward to about the 49. Receiver. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position of this football game. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And here we go with the offense ready to get things going again. Western Kentucky is up by a touchdown. Gets it. He's in space. And he hits him hard at the 30. Just throws this one away.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Tackle made at about the 39-yard line. Out of bounds at the 42-yard line.
Hey, let's get this, get this. Mike 27, Mike 27, Mike 27.
Little screen pass. And he is drilled at the 42.
steps out
around the 45-yard line. Haggerty is the punter. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt.
Not only did that kick prevent a return, but now he's given them almost a full field in front of him. That's a super effort.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Makes it out to about the 20. It's first and 10. Ball on their own 20. It off. Taken down as he works the left for a nice game. They come out on an empty backfield. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down at the 28, so it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Quick throw. He's taken down right around the 34. Strike complete, and he's down.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about, baby. That's what I'm talking about. High five, baby, high five. Let's go.
Second down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Ready!
Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. And he's taken down at about the 47-yard line. He gets out to about the 44-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Tight right, tight right. Four down,
right nine,
right nine. Patriot, Patriot.
Here we go, checking low.
Come on.
Check the ball, check the ball.
And they'll get him in the backfield. Loss of two on the run by the halfback. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. There's a strike complete, and they push him out at the 32. This is the 10th play of this drive. Fights forward to about the 29. From the 29-yard line, second down.
Let's go!
Now he's scrambling, runs with it, and he's got room. Touchdown, Vols! Be tied with the extra point. And he converts the extra point. Timaglia has his kick team lined up, and he is set to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful.
makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
Throwing the post route in the holes of zone coverage is just pitch and catch for these guys. They make it look so easy.
Out of bounds at the 41. Out of bounds at the 43-yard line. Slings it out there incomplete. Haggerty to punt. From the 15. They'll bring him down at the 30-yard line.
These offenses have just got to go back to the drawing board. Whatever the coordinators drew up this week clearly is not working right now.
Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Gets to around the 42. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 42-yard line. He's scrambling. He's at midfield. And they make the stop
right around the 46-yard line.
Out to around the 38. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. So at the end of the third quarter, this one's all even at 10. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Makes it out to about the 29. First down, 10 to go. Ball in the 29. Is caught, the defense lays him out.
Larry. Mike 9.
Here we go, D.
Makes it out to about the 13. From the 13-yard line, it's first down. Receiver, and he's got it again. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They'd love going to him down here.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was a 7-play, 70-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Like they're ready for the kick. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. going to try and scramble. And down he goes
at about the 45.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
And he's immediately tackled. Fights forward to about the 43. He scrambled, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only do they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that this defense is putting on.
Him down in the backfield.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
Second down, 10 to go. All on the 11. He's out of bounds around the 8-yard line. Only 3 yards there on the throw.
The freshman took the quick pass, but the defense made a very nice read on the play. He didn't have anywhere to go.
Got it on the quick throw. And he's tackled at the 4. So they're going to go for it here. Going to the end zone, and it's coming back out. Tennessee up 7 points. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Positive yardage. And the defense gives up some free yards to the offense.
Penalties can ruin a team's chances to win if they commit too many.
From their own 26-yard line, first down.
Has some daylight.
Nice run there as they work the outside. Chandler gained 7 yards on that play. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. From their own 43-yard line, first down. The give. Tackle right around the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, it's first down. Less than 3 minutes in the game.
Red 18. Delta.
tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down at the 29.
You talk about execution. That is the sixth first down on this drive alone. That's exactly the way the offensive coordinator and this offensive staff has prepped this offense all week. I'm sure they're standing over on the sidelines amazed themselves the way their plan right now is coming into fruition.
They bring the quarterback down.
The Hilltoppers are going to call their second timeout. So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at second and 13. He's tackled at about the 23-yard line. Here's play number 10 on the drive.
Great job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9. And a quick throw. Tackle made around the 20-yard line. It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. Tackle made at the 26. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. Second and 10, ball on the 26-yard line. Under a minute left. Throws it. Big yardage on the catch, and he's immediately pushed out of bounds.
I'd go right back to him. He's got the skills to make things happen, and the defense might not be able to keep up at this moment.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. He goes out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 36. Pass to the end zone. It's intercepted, and that should do it. And it's the defense that delivers the knockout punch with that interception. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback. Take a knee. From their own 18-yard line. Second down.
Let's go! Red 68! Red
7! And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. 20-10, Tennessee. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.